1, 1, 2. Check me out right here, yo. In the commission, you ask for permission to hit him. He don't like me, hit him while wifey was with him. You heard of us, the murderers, most shady. Been on the low lately, the feds hate me. Opposition, competition of the day in the life of the commission, commission, commission.
Mic check, what's kicking, family? This is Mr. Batch of the BBC, the Big Blue Commission. Go Big Blue, the G-Men. That's right. Division playoff weekend. The Giants travel to Lambeau Field to take on the Green Bay Packers. The 15-1 Green Bay Packers with Aaron Rodgers and company. But before we get into that, BBCers, I got something here that I'd like you all to peep out. I had saved it from the beginning of the season. Oh yeah, that's right. This is from the Daily News, dated September 7th, 2011. It was the preview to the season, and they have a few interesting things. Before I get to the giant thing in this paper leading up to this contest we have going on, check this out, what they had to say about the Jets. On the cover. Let me make sure I tell you what it said. It says, welcome to New Jet City. Myers, as you know, Gary Myers, if I got his first name right, but he's a sports writer for the Daily News, and that was his article. Welcome to New Jet City. Myers, sorry, Giant fans, but Rex is right. It's gangrene's town now. That didn't happen. That did not happen. Good prognostication and pontification, but it did not come to fruition. All right. Let me make this real quick, because I ain't trying to keep you guys too long here. It's Football Friday, and I know you got a whole bunch of stuff to do. All right, what it said here, the prediction, 12-4, wild card. The pieces are in place for the Jets to make another deep postseason run. Sanchez, what's been going on in the news lately, man, sorry for the kid, man, he's getting beat down. Expect Sanchez to take a step forward in his development. The defense will be among the league's elite once again. Although the Jets match up well against the Patriots, they'll need teams from around the league to help them out and beat New England in the regular season to have any chance of winning the AFC East. Bill Belichick's team has too much firepower to finish fewer than 12 wins, so the Jets will be a wild card team for the third consecutive season. In the end, the challenge of winning three consecutive road games to get to the Super Bowl will prove to be too much for the third year in a row. The Jets will come up one game short of reaching the big game. Well, they're nowhere near being one game short of getting to the big game, because they didn't even make it to the playoffs. Now, let me get to what they had to say about gangrene. And this is my lead-in to this weekend's division game. All right, bear with me. Here we go. Now, the prediction out of the Daily News for that day, September 7th, 2011, the preview football of the season coming up, read as follows. Prediction 9-7. This will not be the disaster that so many are predicting. The Giants have too much talent on both sides of the ball to completely fall apart. Yes, they have issues. The offensive line will take time to gel, and the passing game has yet to click. They also are getting dangerously thin in several key positions and may not be able to withstand another key injury. There's also the potential for a disaster if Eli Manning has another 25 interception year. Even with all those INTs last year and all their turnovers, the Giants still had the talent to win 10 games and were one collapse away from winning 11. They're not as good as they were last year, but they're good enough to make a run at the playoffs. All right. BBC, we're playing with house money. We're going to Lambeau, take on Rodgers and the 15-1 crew. All this deja vu in comparisons to 2007 and the way that we had made our runs previously to grab that chip, all well and fine. That's history. I mean, to me, that's a sign that they're worried about that. Teams are worried about that. That's in their head. That's for us, I think that's a psychological advantage. Because they're like, yo, them kids made a run the last time that they got their defense clicking and they got it all. Yes, we have the chance to get it all. We have the chance to get it all. You know, they said Eli's got to pick it up from the 25 interception season. What did he do? Oh, my goodness. Played at elite level. 49-33 in passing yards. Something like 15 fourth quarter touchdowns to set a season record. Passing Unitas and his brother. Two 1,000-yard receivers. They're talking about the wide receiving game not clicking. The offensive line slow to gel. As you've seen over the last several games and coming into the playoffs, and as we stand now, the running game came around. Yes, we were able to withstand some injuries and get to this point now where we're in the playoffs. Other people have stepped up, and people are coming back and being healthy. So, as they say, taking a run at the playoffs, we're in the playoffs. We're taking that run. You know, you've seen all the numbers and everything like that. And on top of that, the media has taken statements from our players and projected them as declarations of, you know, what they said and who they were, when in all actuality, they were answering questions. Now, let's take JPP, for instance, which is the most recent one talking about a guarantee. You know, he made that statement running off the field. You know. I don't think he was standing. He made the statement running off the field. They ran up on him, stuck a microphone in his face. Hey, JPP, what's up? Blah, blah, blah. Yo, young guy caught in the moment. I like what Tuck had said a few days later on the radio about that. He said, you guys really set the kid up. Y'all set the kid up. You know, I know better than to talk to you guys like that and answer a question like that. But y'all set him up. Okay, rewind to earlier, to like the beginning of the season. Eli Manning stating that, yes, he feels he's an elite quarterback. And then the media is like all over the place. ESPN and bam, bam, bam. Look at his numbers now. We're able to go toe-to-toe with the Green Bay Packers in regular season. And we should be able to go toe-to-toe with the Green Bay Packers here in the postseason in their crib. Brandon Jacobs and Bradshaw, bam. 1-2 punch. We have a healthy defensive line where we don't have to send blitzes. We will have people in their regular positions now. We've got people healthy. We're in position. Hey, one of the scores for the Green Bay Packers in that previous contest was a pick six by Eli. Referees was not giving us any calls. Whenever we're out there, it's like 11 on... How many other referees they got out there? They got like six striped shirts. So it's like 11 on 17 whenever we play. Not using the referees as an excuse, but every team out there has had their issues with the Zebras. Going into this contest, we're playing with house money. Hey, the paper said 9-7. Make a run at the playoffs. proud. I'm proud. We are there. We are there. The opposition is starting to like, oh man, yo, they made a run in 07. And you know, and they bring that, yo, they talk about that. You hear that on ESPN, Sports Talk Radio. You read about it in the papers and magazines and on the blogs. They make reference to it. So guess what? In my opinion, that is a mental advantage for us. They're going to be worried. They're going to be like, yo, yo. They talk about how Romeo Crennel had the blueprint to beat the Packers. You know, it was at their crib, Arrowhead Stadium, yada, yada, yada. But think about it. We've got the package to beat the Packers. We've got it. As you already know, offense, defense, special teams. No turnovers, positive yards. Shut down either one of our wideouts. Shut them down. Pick your poison. Granted that the Packers have a better receiving corps than we do. I'm going to, yeah, come on now. They went 16-1, 15-1. They went 15-1. All right? I'm loving it. I love it. This is gravy. Understand? This is gravy for the Giants. This is gravy. Playing with house money. And I'm enjoying it. I like the fact that they keep talking about this guarantee stuff. I like Antrell Roll, what he said. He said, look, that's what he said. I'm backing him. I'm backing him. I believe there was also an offensive player on the, yes, I believe I heard it, Hakeem Nicks on a soundbite saying that, you know, they were talking about JPP's guarantee. You see how the media wants to, these guys, look, this is the playoffs. This is the NFL. This ain't no other league where you get to come back and play another day. It's one and done. Either you win or go home. So I love the confidence in my crew. Hakeem Nicks said something to the effect that, yeah, he's going to back JPP. So you've got both offense and defense on the same page. We are on the same page. Same page. Perifuel, who signed an extension last year after he got here, is going to be here for a minute. Tom Coughlin, whom I was like, yo, he's got to go. If we didn't go, he's here. And he's the best man for the job right about now. Doing a great job, phenomenal job. Hey, hang out, stick around, make the run. Make the run. Make the run. So, I'm very ecstatic about this. House money, going to Lambeau Field. They worried about our pass rush. They figured that they could, you know, pick us off. Granted, if that pass rush that has to be effective, we got to shut down the run. And we also have to contain Rodgers from escaping out and running for that first down yardage. Love it. Love it. And I will say this in closing. Once we get to our 100 yards, limit the turnovers on offense. The defense, our defensive line, get after Rodgers, shut down the run game, sack Rodgers at least 4 to 6 times. Special teams, do what you have to, and make sure that it happens. And what else am I forgetting? That was offense, defense, special teams. You know, the punting team, they got to watch out for the kick return over there on Green Bay. He's dangerous. So the special teams has to make sure that they take care of that. Now, with that whole package, yeah, we'll win. You know, if you're betting, I'm taking the Giants and the points. We're going to win. Damn, well, Green Bay ain't even going to get close to covering. Got to be confident. It's not a guarantee. It's confidence. And on top of that, once we get past the Green Bay Packers, we will be traveling to Candlestick Park for the conference game. This is Mr. Batch of the BBC. I'm out of here like I stole something. Peace.